So it's only fitting that we're here at the World of Pinot Noir, which has been wonderful, wonderful 2 days, Pinot Noir. But tell me about wine. I went to a seminar earlier and they said that the wine should lead the meal or lead the food. What do you think about that?
You know, I don't have an opinion one way. I don't think there are any rules. I think anybody that says that, anybody that has that strong opinion one way or the other about food or wine, I don't think is thinking about it right. I think they're off kilter to begin with. Mm-hmm. You know, I do both ways. You know, sometimes I'll feel like drinking a certain bottle, but I'll usually want to do it in combination with food. So I'll think, oh gosh, what would go well with it? I think what inspires me more than anything about wine, when to drink it, is the weather. And then if I feel like a certain thing, I might pair the food. I might go either way though. It could go either way depending on the day.
But it really is the weather and the season.
Yeah, but typically, you know, the food would inspire me more than the wine typically. Mm-hmm. If I had to say what would do it, you know, I think it would be that. But the weather is really the driving force.
The driving force for you. That's really interesting. Mm-hmm. Do you like ciders or beers, or are you?
I never drink beer.
You don't.
Or ciders.
Yeah. Or ciders.
Yeah.
So it's really more wine.
Yeah, strictly wine. I don't do any spirits. You know, I've been drinking and interested in wine since actually high school. You know, we were, strangely enough, I never went through the fruit wine stage in high school. I don't know why, but I was buying, you know, the wine books. I remember as a senior in high school, I bought a wine dictionary and was trying to figure out how to pronounce Cabernet Sauvignon at the time.
When you were 16.
Yeah, when I was probably 17 or so.
And they were drinking Boone's Farm.
Yeah, and I was
raspberry.
Yeah, I was trying to figure out, you know, at that time I thought, you know, this Corbel makes a champagne called an Eau Naturelle, which is a very dry champagne. I'd like to try and see what that's like. You know?
Right.
And so it kind of got started on that kind of frame of mind. And we started drinking some different German wines recently, because those were a little sweeter, I guess.
Right.
As a kid, you probably like those, and I shouldn't have been drinking anything, but the point is, we were kind of, you know, experimenting at that point. And so, you know, that's what was fun for me. So I've been coming to Santa Barbara to do different wine events since probably the early 90s.
It's exciting.
Yeah.
It's great.